this lecture I will be teaching you all the annihilator method. I think in the one of the videos also I have given this, but it is without any voice, so I just made one more video on annihilator. Same problem, y double dash plus 4y is equal to cos of x. So this is y double dash plus 4y is equal to cos of x. Now the characteristic equation is what of this? R square plus 4 is equal to 0. Okay, so let me solve the problem. So basically R square is equal to minus 4. So I will be putting root on both the side. R square is equal to, here also I plus or minus root of minus 4. So if it is root of minus 4, it will be 2i. So here root and that square will get cancelled. So plus or minus, what is root of 4? Nothing but 2, right? So but it will be 2i. Now r is equal to alpha, it's like alpha plus or minus beta I. In this formula, like whatever I got twice in place of beta. Now I write the general solution, the general this thing. Y of x is equal to e raised to power of 0. So c1 cos of 2x plus c2 sine of 2x. Now this is equal to what? Now we know that e raised to power of 0 is nothing but 1. So I will directly write whatever terms c1 cos of 2x plus c2 sine of 2x. And this is nothing but my y of x. Okay. So e raised to power of 0 is 1. And then I will write this term as it is. Next is m of y, let us take. R square plus 1. This is r square plus 1, okay? Is equal to r square plus 1. Now how I got this r square plus 1? How I got this r square plus 1? From here, wait. Okay, so this is the function and this is the characteristic polynomial of an annihilator. And this, the thing was that, the question was cos of x, right? Here, this is equal to cos of x. So if it is cos of x, that means r square plus a the whole square. So here my a is what? 1. So that's why it is like this. R square plus a the whole square. But a is nothing. In place of a, there is what? Nothing. 1 is there. So that's why r square plus 1. Next step is m of, wait, let me write it properly. M of y is equal to y double dash plus y. So after this step, I'll turn the page. So m of l of y is equal to, now we'll find m of l of y is nothing but r square plus 1 r square plus 4 of y is equal to r square plus 1 into cos of x into cos of x. Or should I write it down? Is equal to, now this is, okay, is equal to, let me write down first. R square plus 1 cos of x. Now here what I have done is, r square plus 1, r square plus 1, I have multiplied on both the side of this equation here. But these I have written in terms of characteristic equation, like r square plus 4. Okay, this. Then into y is there. But what I have done is I have multiplied r square plus 1 on both the side. Over here also, I have multiplied r square plus 1. Okay, so this is equal to this. Okay, I was supposed to write this side, but your place is not there, that's why I have to write it here. Okay, next step, wait for that. Okay, now I will be solving for this one. I will be solving for this one. R square into r square will be r4. Okay, this and this I will consider as zero. Characteristic again, I have to find out. So now what I'll do is r raised to power of 4 plus 4r square plus 4 is equal to 0. This is nothing but r raised to power of 4 plus 4r square, like r raised to power of 4 plus 4r square, this into this, plus r square, and then plus 4, this into this, into y is equal to 0. Next step is what? R raised to power of 4 plus 5r square plus 4 is equal to 0. Next step I'll write to be after this page. So r square, then r square plus 4 plus 1 into r square plus 4 is equal to 0. So what I have to do is r square plus 1 and r square plus 4 is equal to 0. Therefore r1, I will take this as r1, okay, r1 is equal to plus or minus I, and r2 is equal to plus or minus 2i. So therefore my, now okay, I will consider for this one, okay, for r1 is equal to plus or minus 1i. Okay, so yp is equal to, for general solution for this one is yp is equal to c1 cos of x plus c2 sin of x. Okay, and the previous one which I have given you all this, you all consider as yc of x, and this is yp of x. Okay, next I'll turn the page. Psi of x is equal to what? Yp plus yc, sorry, this is yc. Now phi of x is equal to, what is my yp? C1 cos of x plus c2 sin of x plus c3 cos of 2x plus c4 sin of 2x. Now we need to find out yb is equal to what we got. So instead of c1 I will be writing, I'll do that. So yp is equal to, this is equal to, okay, let me drop it again. Yp is equal to c1 cos of x plus c2 sin of x we got, right? Now what is my yp dash? Yp dash is equal to minus c1 sin of x plus c2 cos of x. Minus c1 sin of x plus c2 cos of x. Okay, what is yp double dash? Is equal to minus c1 cos of x minus c2 sin of x. Now I have to substitute these values in this y double dash plus 4 cos of x. It is 4y, right? 4y is equal to cos of x. In this I have to substitute these values. Anything again behind also, in what I have to substitute, I said y double dash plus 4y is equal to cos of x. In this I am supposed to substitute, right, the values. So what is my y double dash? Minus c1. What is my y double dash over here? Minus c1 cos of x minus c1 cos of x minus c2 minus c2 sin of x, right? Then plus 4, what is my y value? C1 cos of x plus c2 sin of x. What it is? C1 cos of x plus c2 sin of x is equal to cos of x, this part. What you'll have to do is minus c1 cos of x minus c2 sin of x, right, as it is here, plus this 4 c1 cos of x, 4 c1 cos of x plus 4 multiply with this also c2 sin of x, 4 c2 sin of x is equal to cos of x, write it as it is, okay. This into this is equal to cos of x. Okay, so what I have done, after this step, what step will come? This is c1 minus c1 cos of x plus 4 c1 cos of x. So what I will get is 3c1 cos of x. So that's what I have written it over here. 3c1 cos of x. Next is minus c2 sin of x plus 4c2 sin of x. So I will get plus c2. Sorry. Yeah, plus 3c2 sin of x. Because out of 4 1 goes, then 3c2 sin of x. And next, it is equal to cos of x, which you'll have to write it as it is. Now here what I have done, I have taken this 3c1 is equal to cos of this, the coefficient of this is 1, no? So is equal to 1, this and this. Here it is 1 in front and here it is 3c1. So basically I will get c1 is equal to 1 by 3. But 3c2 is equal to sine of x is there, cos of x is there. So this is equal to 0, I have put. Then c2 is equal to 0. Now these values I have to substitute in. Yeah. are to substitute these values in where? Yp of c1 cos of x plus c2 sin of x. Yeah, from here. Yp of x is equal to c1 cos of x plus c2 sin of x. Now here the value I got is c1 value is 1 by 3 into cos of x plus 0 because c2 value is 0. So that's what I have done over here. Yeah, yp of x is equal to c1 is what? 1 upon 3 into cos of x plus 0. So I'll directly write yp of x. So therefore the final general solution equation is what? Therefore the general solution is, wait, let me write it properly. Therefore, the general solution is yx is equal to 1 upon 3 cos of x plus c3 cos of 2x plus c4 sine of 2x. So what I have done over here is y of x is equal to, now this part is my y of p plus this is my what? So what I have done basically here, this is, yeah, this is my psi of x. Okay, wait, I have done a mistake over here. Yeah, this is psi of x. Psi of x is equal to, yeah, so these values, whatever values are they, have to substitute in this. Psi of x is equal to, psi of x is equal to c1 is what? 1 upon 3 cos of x plus c2 value is 0 and rest remaining I have to write it as it is, c3 cos of 2x plus c4 sin of 2x. So that's what I have done it, the last part. Psi of x is equal to 1, 3 cos. C2 I have not taken because it is 0, right? I hope this video is useful, and if this video is useful, then please do subscribe my channel. I end up my lecture here. Thank you.